a pretty good partner, huh, boss?
Too early to say.
Yeah? Just seeing him come back makes me real proud.
What breed is he? He's not a husky.
You're right. Siberian husky is a cross between a Spitz-type dog and a wolf. I think Dee Dee might have some wolf blood in him, too. He isn't just smart. He's also shown remarkable judgment. If he doesn't do what you want him to, he's just doing what he thinks is right in the situation. And he's steady under fire. Remember, he's no lab dog. But learn his strengths, and you'll understand each other soon enough. You'll make one hell of a team.
Ocelot, why don't you take it upon yourself to train him?
Why?
Yeah. When's the last time you heard a wildcat raising a dog?
I have an eye for him. I know at first glance he'd make the right partner for you.
Huh.
And I figured it was about time he got out into the world.
So you passed him off on me?
There, you see? I knew you liked him.
I don't know about that yet. I still think he's trying to figure me out, too.
I'll spend some more time with him. You'll see how helpful he can be.
What about you?
I prefer to work alone.
Ocelots don't hunt in packs?
Yeah, something like that. Anyway, I'm glad you like him. Dee Dee's really taken to you, too. And to going on your walks. Don't be shy about taking him with you in the future.
I'll think about it.
Originally, Sahelanthropus was going to be a manned weapons platform. I designed a cockpit in its head, and I plan to fill it with water as a buffering agent.
Like how Paz modified Zeke for human control.
Don't compare me to some amateur. I designed it for human control from the beginning. Troll AI. You remember the reptile pod?
The AI that controlled your unmanned weapons.
Attaching it externally makes it vulnerable, so this time I wanted it beneath the armor. Meaning I had to make the AI smaller. I got it down to less than a tenth the size without any loss in computation speed. But it was still too big for the cockpit. There wasn't enough room for the pilot. If I made the head bigger, its body would have to be bigger to support it. Too big to be practical. In the end, human piloting was taken off the table. I tested a remote control system too, but there was the time lag and I wasn't satisfied with its precision either. Plus, it would be useless if the enemy jammed it.
Snake, are you okay? Snake!
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us. Thank you.
Понял. Возможно, это вражеское нападение. Всем быть начеку. Конец связи.
Roger that.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Good.
coming too. Roger that.
Are you okay? Snake!
Oh.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
ЗКП, понял. Всем боевым группам проверить окрестности. Избавиться от чужака. Конец связи.
Sirius Angolis Mfinda oil field, upstream from the landing point. A spill has covered the whole area in crude. A pipeline that crosses the Muneni River failed, and now the shore's a mess. Not to mention the villages downstream have no drinking water. The oil runs to the pipeline from that facility. Taking it out should end the leak. The client this time is an environmental NGO. Destroy the facility. Stop that leak. This may seem like straight-up philanthropy, but there's another reason we agreed to it. The Mfinda oil field was outdated. Abandoned. Then the rebel group UNITA moved in, taking it upon themselves to kickstart operations. UNITA's been rapidly modernizing its arsenal. Rumor has it someone's been selling them U.S. military hardware. Intel's analysis suggests the brokers of front company, Cyphers. Keeping tabs on UNITA can tell us who's pulling its strings. So stay sharp. We started has taken a pretty crooked course these past 9 years. With no other options, soldiers have become dogs of war, sent to conflict zones as private forces, or PFs. Guys we fought alongside are dying all around the globe for no reason, no banner. But it's how they survive. The demand for PFs here in Africa is especially high. Cold War standoffs, resource exploitation, tribal clashes. What's big business for developed countries has only brought conflict here. That mess you're standing in is just the latest example. Talus. It's toxic, but it can also be used as medicine. You've arrived at Masa Village. It's been turned into a supply hub for UNITA, meaning it'll be stocked with weapons and resources. Should be a thing or two that'll come in handy. Don't be shy. They deserve to be in better hands.
Too. Roger that. You gotta extract him. Roger that.
Talk.
Ek praat nie Engels nie. Laat my gaan.
The PF soldiers are speaking Afrikaans, an official language of the Republic of South Africa. Boss, we're gonna need someone with the Afrikaans interpreter skill to understand what they're saying. We'll look into it here, but for now, you'll just have to make do without one. Extract him.
Mm-hmm.
coming too. Roger that.
Oh.
stop the leak, you need to shut down the oil transfer pump and destroy the oily water separator tank. The details are on your iDroid.
Rain. Sound of rainfall should help to mask your footsteps.
Collins is the lingua franca for mercs in that area. If you're going to get any information from interrogations, you'll need an interpreter.
He's coming too. Roger that.
Mercedes, roof here. Circle on a plant. Speed lost upon full contact. Push. The safety is behind. Only 40. Don't follow. 8.
Separator tank. You'll need to use explosives. Got any C4?
Lay off your rudder.
C4. Don't set it off until you're at a safe distance.
Kidding around, Snake?
Snake, talk to me! Snake!
Roger.
Sainer, the owner of the oil field. They were behind what happened. They hired the PF, not UNITA. They restarted the facility all the while pretending they were the victims. One other thing. Sainer's Johannesburg head office is just a room in a multi-tenant building. Company's essentially non-existent. 3 years ago, that investment fund stepped in and started gutting it through a series of mergers and sell-offs, and get this. The fund itself no longer exists either. It's a shell corporation, meaning someone is just using Sainer's name from the shadows. But what about those strange corpses? Just what the hell were they doing over there?
Hey! Snake! I've customized a walker gear just for you. It features a silent running system, great for infiltration missions, and you can also summon it to your location. I've taken the liberty of calling it the D-Walker. It's armed with a suppressed tranquilizer gun. If you want to add other weaponry or upgrade the chassis, give the order from your iDroid.
I've updated the mission list. We've received a new job offer. It doesn't seem connected to Cypher or Skullface at all, but if it goes well, we may get an Afrikaans interpreter. The details are on your iDroid.
There's a violent power struggle going on within the contract forces of Africa. The PF... You call that thing Sahelanthropus. Where does the name come from?
Well, several years ago, an excavation team discovered a hominid skull in the Sahel region.
Central Africa. The Southern Sahara.
Cypher gave the specimen the name Sahelanthropus, Man of Sahel. And then they covered the whole thing up.
Why?
They probably wanted to monopolize information about human evolution to have a head start in their genetic research. At least, until they had an idea of what they'd found.
It was that big of a discovery, huh?
Sahelanthropus was a gracile hominid, estimated to have lived about 7 million years ago. What's significant about it is how its skull's foramen magnum faces down. In other words, its spinal column supported its head from underneath.
It stood upright.
Right. Which would mean Sahelanthropus walked upright 3 million years before Australopithecus, making it the world's oldest human species.
Walking upright. I get it. Hence the name Sahelanthropus for your machine.
Walking upright was the decisive difference between our ancestors and other anthropoids. Our brains could get heavier once they were supported by the spinal column. That led to the use of tools and the development of complex communication through language. Only man is capable of this. My creation will be the progenitor of all bipedal weapon platforms.
And you did this for Cypher?
No, not at all. Sahelanthropus is the best proof that I never betrayed you guys.
What do you mean?
The reconstructed Sahelanthropus skull looked exactly like the skull we used as our logo 9 years ago in the Caribbean.
An army without a nation. Outside the world order.
The design was based on Pangaea, the supercontinent that existed 250 million years ago, right?
Yeah. When the world was a single landmass, that concept's at the source of our strength.
I felt the same way about Sahelanthropus. Sure, I was forced to build it under their orders, but I always wanted to put its technology back in our hands someday. That's the reason I incorporated the old insignia into Sahelanthropus's name. Don't you see? That's how much I was thinking about you guys.
Oh, I see, all right. I see someone desperate to cover his ass. You can say whatever you want after the fact. But that skull also symbolizes somebody else. Skullface.
Snake, you finally came. Just don't record this, okay?
Not recording anything. What's this about?
What I'm about to say stays between you and me. It's about the weapon to surpass Metal Gear. You know a researcher by the name of Clark? He works in the biotech industry. Real advanced stuff. His area is bioengineering. But lately, he's also gotten into genetic research.
Never heard of him.
Well then, what do you know about cloning?
I think I've heard enough.
Hold on, this is important. Cloning lets you create a genetic copy of an organism. You take the nucleus of one of its cells, and you swap it with the nucleus of an unfertilized egg from another member of the same species. They started out working with plants, but since then they've had success with other organisms, including mammals. It's a hot area for a lot of places right now. Corporations, universities, research groups. There's no shortage of scientists out to get famous and patent their work, with morality taking a back seat.
Isn't that a little outside your field?
It's got nothing to do with my research. But I thought it might be of interest to you. Cloning, and Dr. Clark, I mean.
Go on.
Now, this is really highly classified stuff. But I've heard that an American biotech company has successfully cloned a human being. What's more, it happened over 10 years ago, and the researcher behind it was Dr. Clark. You've really never heard of him?
I don't meet many doctors.
This Dr. Clark is a complete ghost, even to others in his field. His age, where he comes from, That might not be his real name. And I can't even say for sure he's a he. Clark's employer, ATGC, its company motto is embracing your hopes, preserving talent.
What does this have to do with me?
Cipher. Dr. Clark works for ATGC, and they have connections to DARPA. Cipher couldn't function without the communications network DARPA's built. Meaning, Cipher has to be a part of the Pentagon. Or at least, the two are joined at the hip. DARPA is a driving force behind human cloning. It's a pretty high priority project for them. And this Dr. Clark, some say he's a pivotal player in Cipher. But that's not all. Every cell nucleus in an organism contains the genetic information for that organism. Think of it as a blueprint for life. Clark appears to be working on how to decode this information and rearrange it at will. If you could do that, it would mean being able to custom design human beings for specific purposes. Can you believe that? Suppose for a moment that this is all fact. A man of your talents, if your genetic information died with you, that would be a terrible loss for mankind. But what if mankind could preserve you for future generations by cloning you?
All right, enough. I get the idea.
Look, I know it's inductive reasoning, but this weapon to surpass Metal Gear they're developing in Africa, I believe it's something that uses this new technology. Speaking as a fellow scientist, it chills me to the bone.
That's rich coming from you.
If genes serve as our blueprint, then I wonder if they include an impulse that drives us to tweak the design. Can you imagine that? Genes, encoded with information that wants its children to decode it. Is life itself putting the direction of our next evolution in the hands of scientists? I guess it would take some real arrogance to believe that. And yet, it could be what Cypher's after.
I think you're barking up the wrong tree. But that was an interesting story. It'd make a good movie.
You have to believe me.
Where'd you hear all this anyway?
Where? I just overheard it in bits and pieces while I was forced to do that research for them.
Right.
Wait a minute. Look, I want to help you. I want to be of service here. I'm risking my life with this.
Is that so? Maybe it's time we brought someone else into the conversation.
No, not him. Not Ocelot. You can't do this!
altitude.
Thank you for getting those animals out, boss.
Yeah,
but I also heard the boss was his mentor. That was why he took his back.
He really has been through hell.
We're here for you if you need combat support, boss.
How about expanding the base, huh, boss? Send me out on my next mission, boss. Boss!
Roger.